Hello, my students. How are you? Did you work out for assignment number 10, topic ionic bonding? Look, today we are going to understand and apply all the conceptual knowledge to command this worksheet to ensure the understanding of covalent bonding. So here we begin with the name of God. The worksheet begins with MCQs. Number one is, which is a simple covalent molecule? When we talk of covalent compounds, we need to get the very clear understanding that covalent compounds exist in molecules. They exist in units. And whenever they are applied with electrical field, they do not respond. Because to conduct electricity, the ions should be present. So covalent molecule is the unit of bonded atoms, maybe two or more than two, in which electrons are shared, mutually shared between atoms. Not they are given or taken. So they will not be able to conduct electricity. The next thing about their volatility. There are many more covalent compounds which have relatively lower melting and boiling points as compared to ionic compounds. But the thing volatility, it relates to their vaporization efficiency. Means if a melting point or the boiling point is lower, the liquid is supposed to be volatile, like as of ethanol, like as of acetone, 56 degrees Celsius as the BP. So the liquid is volatile when its boiling point is lower. But if the boiling point of the liquid is higher as compared to acetone and ethanol, we take example of water, it has BP 100 degrees Celsius. So its volatility must be lower than that of having lower boiling points. So you select the suitable and correct answer for that, applying all of the hints which I have given you. Now we see these circles or balls are representing the atoms of different elements. Now the sample which is given is HCl. It's a gas. HCl molecule comprised of one atom of hydrogen and one atom of chlorine. And we see the hydrogen is very smaller in size as compared to chlorine. So you select this diatomic molecule represented in option A, B, C or D. So you have to look just one thing in this diagram, that it must be diatomic. Now the third MCQ, element X has 6 electrons in its outermost shell. Means it must be belonging to group 6. Yes. How could the element react? If some element or atom has 6 electrons in its outermost shell and it needs only 2 more electrons to complete its octet. So we see what are the options. Option A, by gaining 2 electrons to form a positive ion. When electrons are gained, negative ions are formed, not the positive ions. By losing 6 electrons to form a negative ion. Again, this is omitted, totally opposite links are given. We see option C, by sharing 2 electrons with 2 electrons from another element to form 2 covalent bonds. Yes, we can think of it. Suppose it is oxygen and oxygen has 8 electrons, and out of these electrons only 6 electrons are present in its outermost shell. And if 2 more bonding atoms come and they mutually share, like one hydrogen atom comes to share this electron, another hydrogen atom comes to share this electron, then a molecule of H2O will be formed. So it is possible. Then we see option D, by sharing 2 electrons with 2 electrons from another element to form 4 covalent bonds. It can't be possible because just 2 sharings are done and octet is completed. So I think, what do you think should be the right answer? just select the correct one. MCQ number 4, element V forms an acidic and covalent oxide. Whenever we study about oxides, they are bivalent compounds in which oxygen is bonded to another element. And when information is given that it is acidic oxide, so all of the non-metals should come in mind that oxides of non-metals are mostly acidics, and non-metals have relatively higher number of electrons in their valence shell. So what do you think about having one electron or two electrons? There must be some metals having lower number of electrons in its valence shell. So it can't be possible of that element V must be belonging to metallic side. It must be non-metallic side which has maximum number of electrons like 5, 6 and 7. So select the correct answer. MCQ number 5. When written as the formulae, which compound has the greatest number of oxygen atom? You can't get the right answer unless or until you write the correct chemical formula of all four options. And you see the formula for calcium oxide is CaO. The formula for copper 2 oxide is CuO. Copper 2 means in Roman it is written in bracket. 2 means copper must be present in its 2 oxidation state. The formula for iron 3 oxide is iron is in positive 3 state. Fe2O3 by using the crisscross formula. And the last one is potassium oxide, K2O. So you see which oxide has the greatest number of oxygen atom. Theory section, we have to collect the facts or concepts from different chapters to understand this answer. So I help you here. From the following gases to answer the questions below, you can just make a very quick key for these gases that whenever you understand the chemistry of these gases, where they are produced, where they are applied, and where they are mentioned in the textbook, you will be getting your answers one by one. So first we see the main constituent of natural gas. It is none other than methane from the given option. It's almost 94% or more than 94% found in the natural gas, which is a fossil fuel. It's used by plants in photosynthesis to form glucose. It's very easy that plants are using carbon dioxide and sunlight and their chlorophyll to produce the food in the process of photosynthesis, and glucose is the byproduct and oxygen gas is also produced. But here the question is asking what is used by plants. So that must be carbon dioxide. Produced when aqueous sodium nitrate is warmed with aqueous hydroxide and aluminium foil. This is the reaction which is producing ammonia. Yes, this is the identification reaction for ammonia, for the production of ammonia. The next is a product of incomplete combustion of hydrocarbons. When hydrocarbons are burned in oxygen, they produce heat and carbon dioxide and water. And complete combustion produces carbon dioxide, but incomplete combustion produces carbon monoxide, which is a poisonous gas. Produced by Haber process. Haber's process is industrially used for the production of ammonia, NH3. Formed at the cathode when aqueous solution of sulfuric acid is electrolyzed. The formula for sulfuric acid is H2SO4. And when we start conducting electricity through its aqueous solution, ions which are produced are H+ ions and sulfate ions. Sulfate ions are the anions and H+ ions are the cations. And the cathode is that electrode of the electrolytic cell which is negatively charged. So hydrogen ions go there and gets reduced there to produce hydrogen gas. So the correct answer for section F is hydrogen. I am sure I have explained and helped you a lot to understand and to solve the chemistry of this worksheet. We are revising and applying so many concepts here. So just do understand, take the full benefit of this worksheet, and I will be coming again to help you with more worksheets in future. Just till then, God bless you. Take care and do pass on your comments to answer anything or to those areas or to those sections of this worksheet which are not explained in the discussion. Please do give me your feedback. You are just blank in your feedback side, and I become very restless when you just do not speak out. Okay, class, wish you the good luck. God bless you.